This morning, Senate Democrats are urging Mitch McConnell not to bring the chamber back to Washington on Monday. In fact, Senator Dianne Feinstein is calling on the majority leader to follow the House's lead and reconsider his plan to reconvene next week. But when asked about her letter moments ago, McConnell signaled that he is standing by his decision.
I think we can conduct our business safely. And as I said, we've got a whole lot of other people that are showing up for work during the pandemic. It's time for the Senate to do that as well.
Joining me now, Senate Minority Whip Dick Durbin, a Democrat from Illinois who sits on the Appropriations and Judiciary Committee. Senator Durbin, it's great to have you back on the program. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
So one of your colleagues, Senator Chris Coons, says some of you are seriously considering not returning despite the majority leader's decision that we just played for you there. Give me your quick take on this. Are you considering staying home next week?
Listen, we're ready to go back to work, and there are important things for us to consider. The testing across America that's critical for reopening the economy and dealing with this virus, the Paycheck Protection Program, how it's being administered and who's getting help, which small businesses, whether unemployment checks are coming through. There are so many issues we could be considering. So we asked Senator McConnell, we're ready to come back. Even if it's still dangerous and we're not supposed to leave our homes, we're ready. What is the agenda? Well, he tells us he has a family friend who he believes should be elevated to the federal bench. He's 38 years old. He was judged unqualified. He's from Kentucky and used to be an intern in the senator's office. You can understand why a lot of us are saying, Mr. McConnell, there are more important things than your family friend who has been found unqualified getting a lifetime appointment to the second highest court in America.
So let me pick up on that point that you just brought up, because as you mentioned, there are no immediate plans to take up another coronavirus relief bill. Our reporting also confirms what you said, which is that Mitch McConnell's focus will be on confirming judges. In fact, he told a conservative radio host recently that his motto for this year is leave no vacancy behind. What is your response to the majority leader who wants to make that his priority going forward?
And wouldn't it be nice if his nominees were qualified? Nine of the nominees from the Trump White House for lifetime appointments to the federal bench have been found unqualified. Now, your viewers may be saying, well, give us the numbers for Obama. In 8 years, not a single nominee was found unqualified for the bench. In this case, the man that Mitch McConnell is trying to elevate to the second highest court in the land, lifetime appointment, after 6 months on the federal bench, was found unqualified by the American Bar Association. So it isn't just a matter of filling the vacancy. He wants to fill them with his friends, family friends, former staffers, and those who will pledge loyalty to his agenda.
Let me also get your reaction, sir, to the president's senior advisor and son-in-law, Jared Kushner, about what he had to say about this pandemic. Take a listen.
We're on the other side of the medical aspect of this, and I think that we've achieved all the different milestones that are needed. So the federal government rose to the challenge, and this is a great success story. And I think that that's really, you know, what needs to be told.
What's your reaction to that? Do you see this as a success story? Are we on the other side of this medical moment in history?
No responsible public health expert would back up what Jared Kushner just said. We don't know where we are today. Listen, it's been painful to go through this experience for all of us, certainly those who've lost their jobs, worried about losing their businesses, those who are sick and those who are trying to recover. But to think that we would have to go through it a second time because we jumped too soon is just unacceptable. No, we're not on the other side, according to the public health experts, and that's whom we should trust.
And let me ask you quickly about your state of Illinois. Unfortunately, just topped 50,000 cases on Tuesday, reported the highest number of deaths in a single day since this pandemic began, unfortunately. What would you say to your constituents who are among those eager to reopen up your state?
Well, I'd say to them, just remember the healthcare workers. Think about those doctors and nurses and so many others in nursing homes, hospitals, and clinics risking their lives every single day trying to save the lives of those who are facing this infection. It's an inconvenience, and it hurts for us to be out of circulation and our businesses not to be open. But compared to the sacrifice that these people are making, this is not too much to ask. Let's get this right. Let's make sure the fewest number are sick and the fewest number die. And working together, we can achieve that goal.
Let me ask you about the numbers that came out this morning. Unemployment claims now topping 30 million, or around 18% of the U.S. workforce. Realistically speaking, will Congress pass more legislation to extend unemployment benefits? A lot of folks out there need help from their government. Are they going to get it?
I can tell you we anticipated 4 months of unemployment benefits. I hope that's enough, but I have to tell you honestly, I don't think it is. We need to be prepared to stand by the working families across this country who are desperately trying to pay their bills and keep their families together in one of the toughest economies of my lifetime. We've got to stand by them and stand by state and local governments that are doing their best to serve these very same people, the policemen, the firemen, the first responders. We need to stand by them as well.
Yeah, we certainly hope you guys can do that. Senator Dick Durbin of Illinois, thank you so much for joining us on the program.
Good to be with you.